Okay, now let's take a look at the mobile app, which is even crazier. Everything I'm doing here gets synced. Okay, so here I am on my phone, and I've loaded the LastPass app. You can see it right down here in the bottom left-hand kind of corner there. I'm going to go ahead and open it up. It's going to ask me to authenticate myself with my fingerprint because, hey, we want to keep things secure. So you'll notice here that it just opened me up right away to the vault itself. And again, I can go through and take a look at any of my information. For example, I can open up my Arlo cameras. I can view the information. Looks just like the web interface. I could hit the little eyeball there to see my password, but I'm not going to do that. Looks a little short. I think I'm going to go back and change that. I can hit the back button, hit the hamburger menu up at the top, and I can then select, obviously, my secure notes. Remember all those notes I was talking to you about? And you can see I've got some secure notes here. I can go in and you notice I've got things like credit card payments. You'll notice here I've got options in here for my payment cards, my bank accounts, driver's license, passports, all kinds of fun things. But what I wanted to show you is how it works on the mobile app. Okay, so let's see. I'm expecting a package, and so I want to install the FedEx app. I'm going to go ahead and select FedEx. I'm going to go ahead and hit install. Now, I'll be honest with you. I don't know if I have an account or not with them. If I don't, that's cool. We'll create one on the fly. If I do, it's not a problem because LastPass will remember my username and password. And that's why I'm a firm believer in uninstalling apps on your mobile devices that you don't use. When I'm not traveling, I don't have Uber installed. When I travel, I install it and LastPass logs me in. So I'm going to go ahead and hit open. I'm going to allow it to know my location because, you know, FedEx needs to know where my house is, I guess. I'm going to go ahead and hit, I've read the EULA. That's short for the user license agreement. I'm going to go ahead and hit accept. It's going to give me some little directions on how to use the product or this particular app. I'm just going to go ahead and hit skip here. And again, what I want to do here is I want to hit the hamburger menu up at the top. And I'm going to select to log in. And let's see what happens. Typically, you just type on the user ID and LastPass kicks up normally. Sometimes you have to hit the password. Yep, so it looks like I don't have anything listed here. So let's go down here and sign up for an account. So I went ahead and put in my personal information. It asks for my email address, which I'm going to just use my dale@gmail.com. Give myself a user ID. We'll say it's SuperDale. And then we're going to create a password. Oh, look, they're telling me that it needs to be at least 8 characters, 1 number, 1 uppercase. Notice that LastPass also kicked in and said we couldn't find any matches. But, you know, hey, that's okay. We're going to just pop out of there and let's get that back up. There we go. We're going to hit the plus sign. And it says, okay, what's your username? Well, I'm telling it it's going to be SuperDale. And password, see the little lock and the circle on the side? I'm just going to tap that. And it's going to create a password for me. I'm going to go ahead and hit save. I'm going to hit save in the upper right-hand corner. And it's added it to my vault. So I'm going to switch back over to my application here. And now when I click on it, look, FedEx SuperDale. Are you sure you want to do fill-ins for this particular page? This is a security feature. I'm going to go ahead and hit, yep, I want to go ahead and fill it in. There it is. There's the password. We're going to come down here and we're going to paste that in. Once my secret question. I'm not going to show you which one I'm going to use here. And I'm going to hit sign up. Notice it says we saved the username, email, and the password to LastPass. Yes, we want to save. And now you'll notice that I'm logged in as Dale. Again, I can log out. And if I go to log back in, now LastPass should kick in when I hit that password field. There's my SuperDale. Yes, I want to allow that. That's kind of weird that popped up a second time, but that's okay. I'm going to go ahead and hit log in. Filled in the password. Again, I don't care to know the password for every single app. I can forget those things and make room in my brain for more important things, like my anniversary day. I know, isn't that crazy how easy that is now to handle your passwords? I love the secure note feature, isn't that great? I don't have to worry about where's my driver's license. I can always pull that back up. If I discover a breach in Facebook, I can just simply change my password very easily. So now I only have to remember one password. And that password, again, your master password, it needs to be long, at least 16 characters. And it needs to include the complexity requirements like lowercase, uppercase, special characters, and a number or two. And if you need some suggestions on how to create a long password that's 16 characters, just string some words together. Carrot, goat, tank top. Yeah, I've never seen a goat wear a tank top. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. Something to help make you and your family more secure. If you'll do us a favor and do what everybody else tells you to do to support the channel, you know, hit the subscribe notification button, that would really help. If you want to leave some comments, that's great too. In fact, if you want to see some particular products out there and want to know how to secure them for your family, let us know.